Bobcat Goldthwait.
Please don't take this the wrong way. Where am I?
This is like a weird little room that we have here.
Is this?
Where, believe it or not, like some pretty big artists have performed in here.
I don't question that at all, but I do feel like I'm in someone's rumpus room.
If you don't look that way, if you just look this way, trust me, the video is going to look awesome.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Mom, I'm doing a show. Quiet.
Yeah. I mean, it does feel like somebody's basement.
It's a little bit like a basement, but I feel a little bit like Rupert Pumpkin.
You're in town at the Punchline this weekend. I got to see the show last night, and I was telling people when I came in, honestly, it was, and this is not blowing smoke up your ass, one of the greatest comedy shows I've ever seen.
Oh, my God. Well, now would be time for my untimely demise, I think.
Go out now.
Yeah. How am I going to top that for the rest of the week?
Because
the rest of the weekend, I really think I'm going to phone it in.
Well, good. Then I'm glad I got to watch you exercise.
Yeah. Well, you said that it was one of the best shows you've ever seen. Thank you. That's very kind. But, the pressure's off.
Yeah. So you can go this weekend and see him, but it's not going to be as good as what has already happened.
You see me Thursday. I really blew everyone's asses through their faces, but you know.
I've always been a fan of your stand-up comedy. But what I love now though is how you have truly become a prolific director, writer and director. And
thanks. Yeah, a lot of folks don't know that, and it doesn't hurt my feelings. It's just I live in a very strange world. You know, I go out and I do stand up, and it helps me there's a connection with the live audience. It makes it so I don't have to do the kind of movies that I was in. I don't have, as a writer and director, I don't have to be in things that I don't necessarily, you know, that I don't,
totally know what you mean. Yeah, it's if you watch a Bobcat Goldthwait movie now, you're like, oh, the guy from Police Academy is directing this movie. I'll check it out. It's probably delightful. I love Hot to Trot. And then you watch, you know, World's Greatest Dad, and you're like, what happened to him?
Yeah.
But it's
kind of really how I've always seen the world. These movies And I think it even probably is a bit of a reflection of my early stand up. It's just, I think, you know, in between the things that folks know me for, are watered down versions of my original stand up. You know, sometimes when I hear myself talk now, I would punch me in the throat.
Why?
Because I'm just like, you know, as a comedian, I should be funny, and now I'm sitting talking about my earlier work.
Well, but you know. Your films are still funny. You know, the one that's on now, your last one, Call Me Lucky,
right,
which is on Netflix now.
Yeah, it just came to Netflix. Yeah.
I encourage everybody to watch it.
Oh, thanks.
It's a documentary.
Yeah.
And it's about Barry Crimmins, who was a comic who became a crusader.
Yeah.
And it is, I'm not going to get dark, but I saw that movie right after a very tragic thing happened in my life. Mm. And it was one of those movies that made me laugh, but also reminded me that the world is dark and that there are good people that will help you get through it.
Yeah. I guess that's the thing about what Barry, well, thank you. But I think, I think that's part of Barry's message is that there are, you know, that we can change the world, which sounds pretty lofty to say, but I mean, I think it's a
in
movie.
Small ways.
I think it's about a movie about not giving up.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and helping each other, which, you know, obviously with the recent events that is a good message to put out in the world, but it's a very heavy movie, like, you know, and I'm sorry to hear about, some rough events in your life. It's been a heavy year, you know, doing that movie and other things that I've gone through this year. So it's really, you know, I really thought like my next move as a guy making movies was going to be like, I'll do a talking duck movie or something. But I kind of think that I may even end up doing like a darker movie.
Is that possible?
it might be.
Because World's Greatest Dad, I recommend World's Greatest Dad to so many people, but I always preface it, though, with, like, it goes to some dark places,
right.
But you're going to see a performance from Robin Williams that's better than anything in Good Will Hunting.
Oh.
And... Ooh. And I mean, would you say? I mean, it's weird because
well,
you'd be
no,
a little biased.
I mean, I feel that I mean, I know that he really was proud of the movie. He was proud of Good Will Hunting too. I think his performance is there's other movies that he's probably similar. But often when Robin was in a movie, it was as if like. People were. I almost felt like he wasn't secure in a strange way. Like it was just like, well, go crazy, Robin, you know. And and in our movie, it was about him, you know, really stripping everything away and trying to just be himself, which was funny because he decided that he was playing me. Like a couple of days in, he goes, "I'm playing you, aren't I?" And I was like, no. And my family's behind him going, yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's great. One thing I love too, and we'll kind of end on this because I'm personally curious, but, you know, you've done comedies, dark comedies. You've done documentaries. You even did a horror movie, Willow Creek,
which was
a really, really fun movie too.
Oh, thanks.
What's next? As far as your film directing goes.
Well, I mean, I actually written all different kinds of movies, you know, and I hope to make them. You know, I wrote a musical.
Can you tell us anything about that?
Well, no, because, I mean, I want to get it done. And if I talk about it, people are going, hey, I thought that musical was going to go. But there's that. And, you know, I wrote, you know, Willow Creek is a scary movie, hopefully, for people. But
yeah.
it's a suspense movie. And then I actually wrote a really gory movie. And then I wrote...
Are you talking about God Bless America, or is this something else that you're working on?
No. I wrote a really gory, a zombie fetus movie, you know. It sounds like I'm making light of it, but like I wrote a gay action hero, you know. It's like a karate movie, but with this really tough ex-marine.
That's a great action. I mean, that's something to cross off next.
Yeah. It's a martial arts movie.
I can't wait. I honestly, dude, I can't wait. And I know we got a little heavy during this interview, but
no, that's all right.
Your show is hysterical. I recommend everybody go check it out.
Thanks.
And it was so nice hanging out with you. Thank you
Thank
very
you.
Much, man.
Thanks for having me on.